Will you be ready? Will you be ready? That's the question that I'm asking. Because we live in a time that where we are being attacked. We are being spiritual attack. We are being cyber attack. We are being attacked on in constructor. So my question to you all, will you be ready? And glory to God. My friend, I'm going to be ready. Because Jesus Christ is my guide. Jesus Christ is my God. And Jesus Christ is good. And my question to you all, will you be ready? Because a lot of people was not ready. We got people that stand in line. They went to the AT&T store. And they start cussing out the representatives. Saying to a representative, you should know what to do. But AT&T didn't know what to do. Because they were not ready. My friend, we ain't seen nothing yet. Because we as being Christian, we are pilgrim. We are pilgrim passing through. So we're not going to panic, we're going to praise. We're not going to worry, we're going to worship. Hey, glory to God. We're not going to be terrified, we're going to stay in the truth. Amen. So my question to you is, will you be ready? I think every Christian, under the sound of my voice, you should be ready. Amen. How do you ready? You ready by you praying. Hey, glory to God. You ready by you staying in the word of God. You ready by you being in the presence of the Lord with a fullness of joy at thy right hand, thy pleasure forevermore. My question to you all, will you be ready? Or let me say it another way. Are you ready? Hey, glory to God. Are you ready for the second coming of the Lord? Are you ready for the devastation? Hey, glory to God. I will listen to this lady. Hey, glory to God. And she was in an accident. And she escaped the accident. Hey, she escaped the devastation of being wounded, bruised, or getting killed. And she testified saying that she was not ready. My question to you all, when will you be ready? Hey, glory to God. My friend, it's just like those foolish virgins. Those foolish virgins, hey, glory to God, they had a lamp with no oil. And there are a lot of people have a body, hey, glory to God, but you don't have God living in that body. Hey, man, you playing patty cake, bakers, man. You playing Humpty Dumpty, stand on the wall. You playing all these games, but you're not with God. Hey, man, and I'm telling you, when will you be ready? My friend, hallelujah, I'm ready now. Hey, man, see, I'm not afraid to die. Hey, man, there are a lot of people under the sound of our voice, you are afraid to die. You are afraid to meet your maker, hallelujah, or your breaker. Your maker is God, and your breaker, glory to God, is the devil. So my question to you all, will you be ready? Hallelujah. Back to the virgin. And the Bible say, those foolish virgins, they had a lamp and no oil in it. And so that means that all their life in church, and it was plain church. All their life in church, and they were churchy. Amen. It's a lot of people, hallelujah, glory to God, they in church. But my friend, you are so close, but yet lost. Well, I say, you are so close, hallelujah, but you are lost. Anytime you're a person that read your Bible, you're a person that pray, you're a person that in the presence of God, and you ain't taking salvation seriously, glory to God, you are so close. And there are a lot of people, like people was panicking, people was crying. This one young lady, I was watching it. Hey, glory to God, her cell phone cut off. Hallelujah. She was going the direction, and she was lost, and she was crying. Hallelujah, glory to God. It's just like Esau lost his blessing. Amen. And he was crying to his father, saying, Father, do you have one more blessing for me? Oh, glory to God. I come and tell somebody, When will you be ready? A lot of people are playing with their soul. Hallelujah. How you play with your soul? My friend, you're not serious about your soul. You're not serious about salvation. You're not serious about your salvation, my friend. You're not serious about the Savior of the universe. My friend, when will you be ready? Hey, glory to God. My friend, we ain't seen nothing yet. What happened to cut off the water? What happened if we're in darkness? Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. We got to use candles, and the candles are all sold out. Hey, glory to God. Our mechanism to keep us light is all sold out. What are we going to do? That's why we got to prepare ourselves. How you prepare yourself? Being the presence of God. How you prepare yourself? By being praises to God. How you prepare yourself? By worshiping, not worrying. Hey, not worshiping things, but worshiping Him who art in heaven. Hallelujah. I'm telling somebody right now, my friend, when will you be ready? I'm talking about, are you saved right now? Have you submitted your life to Jesus Christ now? Now, the Bible says, save now, I beseech thee, O Lord, send prosperity now. Oh, glory to God. Now is the day of salvation. The Bible says, today you hear His voice, harden not your heart. Oh, glory to God. My friend, the Bible says, boast not for tomorrow, because we know not what tomorrow may bring. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. You can't boast for tomorrow. Tomorrow, my friend, it's not about tomorrow. We gotta stop procrastinating and, hallelujah, get on board with God. My question to you is, when will you be ready? Be honest. You watch all my videos. You comment. Some people don't comment on my video. Hey, glory to God. I don't know why. Some people don't give me a thumbs up. I don't know. And the righteous run therein, and they are saved. Some of y'all run to the witch, my friend. Hey, glory to God. The Bible have the answer. All answer is in God. What I say? All answer is in God. Oh, glory to God. But some of y'all love going to the witch and forget about the word. And the witch got the audacity to conjugate the word. They use spell on the word. Glory to God. They try to use, hallelujah, Psalms and Proverbs and Deuteronomy to cast spell on people. But I come and tell you, my friend, hey, glory to God, when will you be ready? The ready or not, he's coming. My friend, China, I don't know if China was involved. I don't know if Russia was involved. I don't know how those foreign countries was involved. I don't know, my friend. But I'm saying to you that's listening, when will you be ready? Ready. What is ready? Ready might be those five wise virgin, those five wise virgin had oil in their lamp. Can I ask you a question? Do you have oil in your lamp? The oil represents the Holy Ghost. Do you have the Holy Ghost? I'm not talking about shout. I'm not talking about, I ain't talking about tongues. I'm not talking about dancing and shouting. I'm talking about the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost, but the Bible say, my friend, when the Holy Ghost come, He will lead you and guide you into all truth. The Holy Ghost. But will you be ready? Will you be ready when Jesus come? Would you be ready when devastation come? My friend, hey, glory to God. You don't get ready because God fed Elijah with a nasty bird. Hallelujah. What's that? Hallelujah. Elijah was fed. Hallelujah. God commanded a bird to feed the prophet. Hallelujah. And if I'm a servant of God, God not going to see his children hungry. When I say God not going to see it make his children hungry. If God fed, hallelujah, glory to God, the multitude with three bread and two fish, my friend, God fed 5,000. Imagine. Hallelujah. If anything happened, God gonna take the church out of here. We're gonna be raptured. We're gonna be gone. Hallelujah. We're not gonna be here. That's why I tell people, if you read Revelation, the church was not in the tribulation. The church was taken out of tribulation. Hey, glory to God. And whatever come this world, my friend, I wasn't even affected by the cell phone not working. Well, I say I was not effective. Hallelujah. I didn't notice. Because, see, my life is surrounded with God. My life's surrounded with the Holy Ghost. So I wasn't in panic. I wasn't, glory to God, worrying. I see a tower, say a tower's down. But my question to you is, will you be ready? Some of y'all playing with God. Some of y'all not filled with the Holy Ghost. You're going to be like the foolish virgin. You're going to be left behind. You're going to be knocking, and God going to say, who are you? Who are you? Oh, glory to God. And the Bible say, when the door is shut, hallelujah, you can't open it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So my question to you is, when will you be ready? Amen. Hallelujah. And let me go back to the witches, my friend. Let me go back to the witch. Some of y'all communicate with a witch too much. Y'all asking a witch question rather than asking God. See, Saul, the first king of Israel, died because he consulted a witch. When God wasn't speaking to him no more by dream, by vision, by Urim and Thummim, by the prophet, he went to the witch. And some of y'all the same way. If God don't communicate with y'all go to the witch. Y'all go to the witch and communicate, and the witch give you wrong answer, and you come back to God and say, God, why? Listen, the word of God gave all the answer. God have all the answer. That's why we have a holy Bible. The Bible was not man-made. The Bible is not a white man book, not a black man book, but it's a Jesus God book. What say? The Bible is a God book. See, that's why y'all going to the witch. Y'all go to the second hotline. Y'all go to the horoscope. Because you don't have faith in the Bible. What say? You don't have faith in the word of God. I have faith in the word of God. I'm going to lean on God. I'm going to depend on God. My total dependency is on God. My friend, I'm not going to panic. I'm not going to worry. I'm not going to be terrified. I'm not going to be crying. Oh, I don't know what to do. I know what to do. I'm going to lean on God. Amen. Because Matthew, if we look at Matthew, the 24th chapter, he gave us an outline of what to come. What it is? He gave us an outline of what to come. Whatever happened in this world, amen, I'm not going to be terrified. I'm not going to panic. Because the Bible says, man's heart failed them because of fear. Why do you think people have heart attacks? Why do you think people have anxiety attacks? Because what happened in February 22nd is what's going to happen. It's a preview of what to come. And if you're not ready now, I'm talking about now. I ain't going to talk about tomorrow. I'm not talking about next week or next month or next year. I'm talking about now. The Bible says, today you'll hear his voice. Harden not your heart. There's no time to have a hard heart. There's no time to procrastinate. It's time to be serious with God. Don't be like the atheist. Don't be like the humanist. Don't be like those that wondering, is there a God? My friend, God gonna snatch his church out of here before something happened. But the 22nd was a preview of what to come. A preview. Hey, glory to God. That's why I'm wrapped up and tied up and twisted up in Jesus. Amen. Because there ain't nothing on this earth left. Amen. But sorrow, crying. If you look at those videos of people was crying, people was cussing people out, they went to the AT&T store, they went to the Cricket store, and they're trying to figure out what happened. My friend, we ain't seen nothing yet. That's why I'm telling you, hallelujah, when you gonna be ready? When? Y'all procrastinate too much. You sit aside, God, you put God on a shelf and pick up on Sunday. You put God on a shelf and pick up on Friday. You put God on a shelf, and the only time y'all cry to God is when y'all in trouble. Only time, glory to God, y'all want God when y'all like the ten leopard. Only one came back and give God the glory. Y'all use God as a crutch. Y'all use God as a sugar daddy. You use God as a genie. He ain't no genie. You can't rub the Bible and things come to pass. No, my friend. You got to live the life. That's why, hey, glory to God, when people quote Isaiah 54:17, it ain't working for you because you're a hypocrite. It ain't working for you because you're a sinner trying to use a scripture. I know we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, but I'm talking about it's time to call the clean and from the unclean. The Bible says, come out from among them and be separate, said Lord. Touch that unclean thing and I receive you on when you will be ready. When? Because the Bible say, glory to God, it's going to come a day, you're going to be like a thief of the night. You're going to be see peace and safety, sudden destruction come upon this earth. But when will you be ready? Brother, sister, when you be ready? Some of y'all don't have a prayer life. Some of y'all don't know such a scripture, for it to think you have eternal life. For they that testify about me. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but by me. The Bible says, neither there's salvation in any other, for there's no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. So are you saved today? Are you sanctified today? Are you separated from the world today? Are you filled with the gift of the Holy Spirit today? When will you be ready? Are you ready today? I'm ready. I'm ready. Glory to God. Dead or alive, I'm ready. Amen. Whatever happened, I'm ready. Amen. Glory to God. How many people can say, I'm ready? I'm ready. Amen. Y'all keep on playing with y'all soul salvation. Hey, glory to God. See, Jesus Christ had 12 disciples and one had the devil. Peter denied him and Jesus Christ betrayed him. And Judas hung himself. And Peter repented himself. So my question to you is, when devastation, when tragedy comes, are you going to have a heart attack? Or are you going to have a hungry and humble for God? That's my question. Are you ready today? Are you ready today to meet your master? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Paul say, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. Philippians say, he that begun a good work in you will perform it unto the day of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Paul was right, my friend. For me to live is Christ and to die is gain. I'm not dying to come back as a pillar. I'm not dying reincarnation. I don't believe in reincarnation. Amen. If you die in your sin, hell is your home. If you die with Jesus Christ, heaven is your home. My question to you is, when will you be ready? Are you ready today? The Bible says, today you hear his voice. God's voice is my voice, because the scripture is God's voice. Amen. That's why John the Baptist say, hey, glory to God, he must decrease and Christ must increase. He said, I'm not even worthy to unloose his shoe. And John the Baptist said, behold, the Lamb of God was coming to take away the sin of the world. There's no more Savior coming. The Savior already came. And his name is Jesus Christ. The second time coming, he's coming as a victor. Amen. Glory to God. And the Bible said, I'm going to reign with Christ. The Bible said, I'm going to judge the world. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to judge the world and judge angels. Will you be ready, sister? Will you be ready when Christ return? Amen. Because if not, amen, you be like a foolish virgin trying to go back and buy some Holy Ghost or some oil. And the Bible say the bridegroom came and the door was boom shut. And they came knocking. And Jesus Christ said, I never knew you. Depart from me, workers of iniquity. The Bible say in Matthew 7:21, not everyone say, Lord, Lord, going to enter the kingdom of God. But he that doeth the will of my Father. Many will say, Lord, we prophesy in name. Lord, we cast out demon. Lord, we've done many wonderful works. Works won't get you to heaven. Cast out demons won't get you to heaven. Amen. Prophesying or preaching won't get you to heaven. What gets you into heaven? Jesus Christ told the disciples, don't rejoice because the angel, the Satan is subject unto you, demons subject unto you, but rejoice because your name is written in heaven. Rejoice for that. Amen. Come on now. Is your name in heaven? You should know if your name in heaven. I know my name in heaven. Glory to God. Amen. I know my name is in heaven. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Can I say that about you? Do you know your name is in heaven? Be honest. Come on now. If you doubt, it's time for you to repent. If you doubt, it's time for you to return. God told the church of Ephesus, hallelujah, you're forsaking your first love. Repent. Repeat. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And come on back home. Will you be ready when Christ returns? Amen. Glory to God. We don't know the day or the hour. I'm not calling no days. I'm not calling no days, no when he coming back, no time when he coming back. I know he's coming. Don't be like the wicked servant, beat his servant and say the Lord delay is coming. He ain't coming. I'm telling you, he's coming back. He's coming back, sister. But my question to you all that's listening, I know my site, I know my channel not popular. Amen. I know I don't have all the gauges and all this, my friend. But I'm telling you, will you be ready when Christ returns? Will you have a heart attack when they cut the water off? Will you have a heart attack when the light turned off? Will you have a heart attack when your phone service not working? Will you have a heart attack when there's a famine in the land? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm saying to you that's listening, will you be ready? Or let me say, are you ready now? Are you ready now? Amen. You can be ready now, sister. Yes, yes, brother. Yes, you. Yeah, you can be ready right now. How you be ready? By you be like Nicodemus. Nicodemus came to Jesus Christ by night and said, Rabbi, we know that thou teacher come from God. Can no man can do this miracle that thou doest except God be with him. Jesus Christ said, Verily, verily, I thee, shall a man be born again, he can't see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said, how can a man be born? Shall he enter the second time in his mother's womb and be born again? Jesus Christ said, no, Nicodemus, you must be born of the water and born of the spirit to enter into the kingdom of God. In verse 7 say, you must be born again. Hallelujah. To be born again, that means that you're ready. Now. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Will you be ready? Are you ready now? A lot of people playing with their soul salvation. Hey, glory to God. My friend, sex is not all that. Sex is overrated. Being married is overrated. Being a millionaire is overrated. Have a nice house and all this money in the bank is overrated. Because guess what? You're going to leave all those things behind. I never seen a hearse and a U-Haul truck. Hallelujah. Glory to God. What you saying, preacher? Hallelujah. I better get my soul right. Then worry about some cars. Worry about some clothes. Worry about some cash. Worry about some castle. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But I'm worrying about Christ. When I say I'm worrying, I'm worshiping Christ. Because a rich young ruler, his priority was not in the right place. When Jesus Christ said, go sell what you have and give to the poor. The Bible says he walked away sad. He walked away pitiful. He walked away and said, Jesus, I don't want what you have, Jesus. And a lot of people are like that right now. They don't want salvation. They don't want to serve the Savior. They don't want the Holy Spirit. But what they want? They want silver and gold. My friend, hey, glory to God. Silver and gold. Peter told a man at Beautiful, at the gate called Beautiful, he said, silver and gold have I none, but such I have, I give unto thee. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. I'm telling you, if you're not ready, rise up and be ready. How you ready? By you confessing your sin, hallelujah, and believe in your heart that God have raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Today is the day. Woo, hallelujah. I'm telling somebody right now, you ain't seen nothing yet. The water, Food and light, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. The communication tower was the first sign. Next is coming. Hallelujah. Will you be ready? My friend, my hope is I don't be down here when it's happened. Hallelujah. God gonna rapture his believers. Look at how God works. Look how God works. Hallelujah. When there was gonna be a rain, hallelujah. Well, five was in the ark. Five person was in the ark. When God rained down on Sodom and Gomorrah, only four came out, but three escaped the fire. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Miss Lot looked back and turned molten salt. She looked back and turned a pillar of salt. What I'm saying, Jesus Christ said, remember Lot's wife. Remember Lot's wife. Y'all have amnesia. Y'all don't remember. Glory to God. Y'all still dipping and dapping. Yo, glory to God. Y'all still partying. Y'all still banqueting. Y'all doing all these things. Y'all still whoring. Hallelujah. Y'all still getting married and divorced and married. Y'all still homosexual. Y'all still transgender. Y'all still lesbian. Y'all still bisexual. Oh, glory to God. Y'all dressing like y'all prostitutes in the house of God. My friend, when will you be ready? That's my question. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Will you be ready? Because ready or not, Christ is coming back. Ready or not, Christ is coming back. Ah, say Christ is coming back. Ready or not, Christ is coming back. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory to God. Glory to God. Christ is coming back. Will you be ready? That's my question to you. And that's my final. God bless.